Hello and good morning to one and all. And just now, children, I am going to teach the lesson Bipin Chaudhary, Lapse of Memory. We have already, completed 3/4 of the lesson, and today we will be completing the lesson. But before starting, children, the reading and explanation of the lesson, I would like to revise all the important points of the lesson. So first of all, Bipin Chaudhary's Lapse of Memory is written by Satyajit Ray. So who is the writer here? He's a very famous writer. It is written by Satyajit Ray. I hope you all can see it. Okay, I hope you can all see the board. Okay, clearly. Satyajit Ray. Alright, so he is the most famous writer. And directed some film also, and I think this name is not a I think this name is very much familiar to you. Now I'm going to tell you about the background of the story. That Bipin Chaudhary was the name of a person who was a middle-aged man, and he was living alone. His wife died 10 years ago. He had a brother who had also died in the mental hospital. Now Bipin Babu, though he was a middle-aged person, but he had a job. He was doing a job and students. Daily he used to leave for the office, and in the evening he used to come back. He was coming in his car from the office, going and coming from his own car, and he had a driver. Now every Monday, he instructed his driver to take his car to the new market to buy a book. Children, at that time, internet and all that thing were not popular. This television, even that was only few metropolitan city had a TV. Okay, so his favorite pastime was to read the books. Now every Monday morning he come to a new market and he used to buy the books, which were generally children books. They were related with crime stories, ghost stories, thriller stories. And he used to leave alone. He used to book 4 and 5 books together so that for the whole week he could pass his leisure time by reading those books. He had not many friends. One day, children, Bipin Babu, when he went to the market to buy those books, he felt that somebody is observing him. Somebody is seeing at him. Now, children, at first he neglected this thought, and then this idea came to him that Bipin Babu, children, the thing which he felt, it was true also. When he turned round, okay, in the beginning he thought that it is his unnecessary thought is coming to his mind, but then again when he realized this thing that somebody is looking at him, he just turned round and saw that a man with a round face was looking at him. And children, when Bipin Babu saw him, he smiled at Bipin Babu. But children, the thing was that Bipin Babu was not able to recognize him. He reminded Bipin Babu that once he had been to Ranchi in 1958, the man had arranged a car for him to take him to the Hoodoo Falls. His name was Parimal Ghosh. Now children, there are 4-5 person name is there, and you should remember these name, okay. And generally children, these names are Bengali name, because Bipin Babu, Bipin Chaudhary, he was from Bengal, because we knew that he went to one of his friend house to celebrate Durga Puja. Okay, so when Bipin Babu looked at him, he gave a nice smile to Bipin Babu, but he was Bipin Babu was unable to recognize him. He was not able to identify that man. Well, children, the man told Bipin Babu that he was the person who had arranged a car for him to take him in Hudro Falls in the year 1958 when Vipin Babu visited Ranchi. And he told his name was Parimal Ghosh. So children, by which name he introduced himself to Vipin Chaudhary? He told that his name is Ghosh. And he told that in 1958 he was in Ranchi. Not only he was in Ranchi, he helped Bipin Babu to children. He helped Bipin Babu helping him to arrange a car so that he can go to Hudro Falls, which was a very famous place in Ranchi. So he reminded, but children, Bipin Babu was not able to identify that person. But Bipin Babu's played a trick on him. He was sure that he had never been to Ranchi, at least in the year 1958. So children, as far as he remembered Bipin Babu, he remembered this thing only, that in the year 1958 he was not in Ranchi. Parimal was surprised. He gave several instances in his support. Now children, that person Parimal Ghosh, he was really surprised. He gave a lot of example to Bipin Babu that he was in Ranchi in the year 1958. But children, Bipin Babu was not able to remember anything. Now he told Bipin Babu that children, when he went to Hudro Falls, he had fallen down in Hudro Falls and got a cut on his knees. And he had arranged the bottle of iodine to him. He had fixed up a car for him to get to Netra Hut. He told me when he fell down near Hudro Falls, he was the person who had given him the bottle of iodine. And so, you know children, why we use iodine in the wounds, because our wounds healed up quickly. And children, it gets dried up with the help of the iodine. So when he had got his cut in his knees, he was the one, Parimal Ghosh was the person who had helped him to put iodine on his wound. And later on children, he had fixed up a car for him to go to Netra Hut. Netra Hut is a place in Ranchi. Now children, Bipin Babu was not able to remember anything. So he reminded Bipin Babu that he had stayed in Dinesh Mukherjee's bungalow. So children, another person was So he told Bipin Babu children that he will be staying in Dinesh Mukherjee's bungalow. He stayed when he was in Ranchi. He stayed in Dinesh Mukherjee bungalow because he did not prefer a student that he should stay in the hotel. He preferred that he should be staying in the house of some of his friend. And it was luckily children, Parimal, Dinesh Mukherjee's bungalow, when he went there, they only had asked him to stay there. But then again, Bipin did not remember all this thing. Well, Parimal Ghosh reminded him that he always carried a book bag at his sightseeing trips. And in that book, children, so many things was written about that place, sightseeing trips. But nothing could revise Bipin Babu's memory. He said that he was in Kanpur in 1958. Now children, he tried hard to remember, and whatever he was telling children, he was telling the truth. So again children, children wanted to remember that where he was, and suddenly Bipin Babu remembered that he was in Kanpur in the year 1958. Parimal told that Bipin had no children and his wife had died 10 years ago. Now, children, Bipin was shocked when he told, started telling about most of his personal things, like he don't have any kids. Bipin Babu did not, he was not blessed with any child. He was not having any child, and his wife had died 10 years ago. And in the same year, his brother, he also died in Ranchi Medical Hospital. Children, but then also Bipin was not able to remember that he was there in the year 1958 in Ranchi. Well, children, till now Bipin was able to, Bipin was having this thing in his mind that he had an excellent memory. But now, children, he had a question mark on him. He was thinking, this man is telling each and everything true. His brother died in Ranchi Medical Hospital. His wife also died 10 years ago. He was not having any kid. And whenever he used to go, he used to carry some bag. Then why he is not able to remember that he was in the Ranchi in the year 1958? Okay. And he was, children, and till now, children, he had a faith in his, he had believed that he had an excellent memory. He was still working very hard in the office. And children, the job which was given to him, it was a job which was full of responsibilities. He wondered how Parman knew all intimate details about his wife's death. Now, children, the question mark he was having at the same time, he was thinking, but Parman knew all intimate details, like about his wife's death and his brother's insanity. But at the same time, he was sure that he was not in Ranchi, but he was there with his friend Haridas Bakchi's house. So the third person is here, Haridas Bakchi. So children, it was the, he remember that in 1958 he was in Haridas Bakchi house to celebrate Durga Puja. But children, still he was not able to believe that Parimal Ghosh, he knew a lot of things about him, and whatever he told was the, children, fact he had till now he had discussed with Bipin Chaudhary. Okay. So student, he was the person who has Haridas Bakchi. He was with Bipin Chaudhary in 1958 in Kanpur to celebrate Durga Puja. Okay. Well, children, now Bipin Babu was really worried. He was thinking all the detail which was told by children, Parimal Ghosh was very much true. He knew all about his intimate details. Then why he is not able to remember that he was in Ranchi in 1958? Ki children, he had a feeling that he was losing his memory. Well, children, suddenly, children, when he was taking the next lunch that day, he is Chunni Babu, one of his colleague when they was young, when he was in his childhood. Chunni Lal, he was there in the school with him. So Chunni Lal came to him, and actually he used to come to children, Bipin Babu's. So he in children, he used to think that Bipin Babu will help him getting a job somewhere. So he often used to come to his house. So that day Chunni Lal came to his house. Okay, Bipin was not able to, he was so much worried about his memory that he did not feel like talking to him. But when he told his servants to tell Chunni Lal to go away right now because he is not feeling well. But then suddenly he ran after Chunni Lal to ask that whether he was in Ranchi in 1950 or not, because he was his friend also. And he knew about his life of the past. So he ran after him. He told Chunni to stop. And he asked Chunni, did you remember, children, Chunni Lal, that whether I was in Ranchi in 1958 or not? Now Chunni Lal asked, when he saw his condition, he looked a bit worried. And he told that, hey, what happened to you are you not feeling well? He told, I am very much feeling well, but please help me in telling that whether I was in Ranchi in 1958 or not. So children, Chunni Lal told him that, did you remember what job I was having in 1958, which job I was doing? So he told, you were there in travel agency. So Chunni Lal told, yes, I was very much there in travel agency. At the same time, I have bought a ticket for you to visit Ranchi in 1958, and I came you to see off in the station. I was at the station to just to see off you when you went to Ranchi. So children, he told Bipin Babu, and then he left the place. Bipin Babu was very much worried now. Okay, then children, again he rang to Dinesh Mukherjee to ask to confirm whether he was in Ranchi in 1958. Dinesh Mukherjee also confirmed that he was in Ranchi in 1958. Now children, Chunni and Bipin Babu, he was really very much worried. He thought that he is really losing his memory. He knew, he started thinking about the death of his brother who died in Ranchi mental hospital. He also knew that he did not had any head injury. In the head injury, people often for children forget their past thing. So he was sure that he did not had any head children injury, and then why he is not able to remember that whether where he was in 1958, when he was in Ranchi, whether he went to Ranchi or he was in Kanpur. And children, he started feeling worried. He was sure that he is losing his memory. Now children, even Dinesh Babu confirmed him that he was in Ranchi and he stayed with them. So he looked more worried. He had to go to see a doctor. He went to see the doctor, and doctor told, this type of case I have not handled anymore. So it's better you go to Ranchi. He advised him to go to Ranchi, and if he will go to the place which he where he had always been there, so he would remember, because when he will see the Hudro, he will see the famous Hudro Fall, many buildings in Ranchi, he would automatically remember that whether he was there in the year 1958. He advised him. Bipin Babu took a leave from his office on the very same day. Children, in the evening he sat on a train and he reached to Ranchi. When he reached Ranchi, he remembered that nothing is familiar to him. He could not remember anything. He was sure that he had not been to Ranchi, because nothing was familiar. He went to Hudro Falls also, where children, his friend Per Parimar Ghosh told him that he had arranged a car for him. So he had left for Hudro Falls also, but there he fainted, children, because lot of exertion and because of lot of worries, he fainted also, and one or two Gujarati fellow picked him up and brought him to the station. He returned back. Children, we are doing the last part, that is the most important part of the lesson. What really happened to him? Was he able to gain his memory, or was he suffering from the lapse of memory? Now we will read the last part of the story. So children, the fourth part of the story. Getting off the train at Ranchi next morning, he realizes at once that he had never been there before. Now children, he went to Ranchi as per the doctor Chandra advice. He had been there, and when he got at the station, what did he saw? He felt at once that he had never been there before. He came out of the station, took a taxi and drove around the town for a while. He realized that the streets, the building, the hotels, the bazaar, the Moradabad, the Morbadi Hills, with none of these had the slightest acquaintance. So children, when he all saw this famous site of Ranchi, he was sure that he did not had any children earlier. He did not went to those places. He thought, why don't he take a trip to Hudro Falls? Maybe that may help him to remind that he was in Ranchi or not. He went there also. Okay. He did not wish to leave with the feeling that he hadn't tried enough. Now children, again he wanted to go to Hudro Falls, because he did not want to return back to his place. At least he should he should know that he had tried enough, whether his he was losing his memory or not. Or children, he arranged a car and left for Fudrufall also in the very afternoon at 5 o'clock. The same afternoon in Hudru, children, he got fainted. Two Gujarati gentlemen from a group of picnickers discovered Bipin Babu lying unconscious beside a boulder. Now, boulder means a stone was there where he was. He lied unconsciousness. Two Gujarati fellow who were there in a picnic, who went to enjoy their picnic, they, children, helped Bipin Babu. Okay. And children, the first thing Bipin Babu said when he got his conscious back, he told, "I'm finished. There is no hope left." Children, why he told this thing? Because he knew by seeing that place that he had never been to Ranchi. So now, children, he was feeling afraid. He had already seen that his brother died in the mental hospital, and he was having a lapse of memory, so his condition will also be the same. So he was really scared. Okay, now children, next morning Bipin Babu was back in Calcutta. He realized that there was truly no hope for him. Soon he would lose everything: his will to work, his confidence, his ability, his balance of mind. Now, children, this type of negative feeling start coming to his mind that very soon he will lose his work, his confidence, his ability, his balance of mind. Was he going to end up in the asylum? At children, he started thinking that was he going to break? That means he will also die like his brother. His asylum, children, is a mental hospital. What is the meaning of asylum? It is a mental hospital. Okay, so his ability, his balance of mind, was he going to end up in the asylum? And Bipin Babu could not think anymore. Now he was so he was so he was intentioned that he was not able to remember anything else. He went to his house. Back home, he rang up Dr. Chandra and asked to him come over. And then Achi, children, wanted to discuss everything with the doctor. He went to have shower, and in the meantime, he rang Dr. Chandra to come to his house so that he can discover. He would like to discuss that he had been to Ranchi, but he was not able to remember whether he was there or not. Children, he went to take shower, and suddenly, children, his servant, he bought a envelope to him. There was a letter. He told this letter, a greenish envelope was there, children, with his name in red ink on it. And in the envelope, children, his name, Bipin Babu, was name was written with the red ink. Above the name, it said urgent and confidential. Not only that, children, it was written urgent and confidential in the letter. In spite of his condition, Bipin Babu had a feeling that he ought to go through the letter. He tore open the envelope and took out the letter. This is what he read. Now, children, he read the letter. He was so excited at why this letter is coming to his home, and it was written urgent. Now, children, let's read the letter and you will know everything. "Dear Bipin, I had no idea that affluence would bring about the kind of change in you that it has done." Okay, so children, it was written there that "Dear Bipin," okay, affluent, children, the state of being rich. What is the meaning of affluence? You can write it, the state of being rich. Okay, so children, it was written in the letter that you wanted to become rich. Okay, and there was a change we have found which was not there earlier. "Was it so difficult for you to help out an old friend down on his luck?" Now, children, and then a line was written there that "was it so difficult for you that you could not help your old friend who was having a bad luck, was really in need of some job. I have no money, so my resources are limited. Now he tell, at that time I was not having any money and my resources were very limited. What I have is imagination, a part of which I used in retribution of your unfeeling behavior. And children, he told ki I did not have any qualification, any talent, only in retribution, children, this, and I have to take revenge because I came to your house several times and you did not help me. And you could have helped me in getting the job, but you did not do that. So he told children, well, you will be all right again now. A novel I have written is being considered by a publisher. Now he's telling ki just now my imagination has helped me to write a novel. Now that novel is becoming famous. A money has been given to me by the publisher. And now, well, you will be all right. If he likes it enough, it will see me through the next few months. And children, if he likes it enough, it will see me through the next few months. That means he wanted to say that if novel will be read by more reader, he will become, people will start recognize him also, and he will be getting more money. Yours, Chunnilal. So children, who was the person who has taken his revenge? His own school colleague. Why he did so? He did so because children, he was expecting a lot from Bipin Babu as he was in good job, but Bipin Babu did not help him. So children, he just wanted to take revenge from him. When Dr. Chandra came to him, he was called by Bipin Babu to discuss the matter because he went to Rachi and there he remembered that he was not able to remember anything. So when he came, he did not tell anything about the letter, that letter was written just to take revenge. Okay. And he told, I'm fine. It all came back as soon as I got off the train at Rachi. A unique case, said Dr. Chandra. He told ki I'm very much fine. I remember everything when I went to Rachi. As soon as I got back from the train, I remember that I was in Rachi. A unique case, said Dr. Chandra. I shall certainly write about it in a medical journal. So Dr. Chandra told this is a very unique case. I will surely write it in a medical journal. The reason why I sent for you, said Bipin Babu, is that I have a pain in the hip from a fall I had in Rachi. If you could prescribe a painkiller. Now at the same time, children, since he fell there in Hodro Falls, so he told ki I want a painkiller, and he did not share his experience that it was actually Chunnilal who was taking revenge from him. So children, we have completed this story. Okay, how did you like this story? It was full of suspense, okay, but it was a nice little story. In this story, writer wanted to give the message, children, we should not be arrogant, okay. We should, even money should not change our mind, power should not change our mind. We should try to help maximum person if we could, if it is in our hand. Okay, so the writer wanted to give the message that children, we should help other, at least we should try to help other. Okay, something is not in our hand. Like Chunnilal came to Bipin Babu's house to get a job. He thought that he is having a nice job. He could also help him in getting a job. But children, unfortunately, this fact was known to Bipin Babu only, that he cannot get him a job. But he did not disclose him. He wanted to avoid him. Okay. And finally, children, Chunnilal was so annoyed. Okay. The moment he got his name and fame, and enough money, okay, he thought of teaching lesson to Bipin Babu. Children, because he was his friend, he was aware of all his intimate details. He knew every personal thing of Bipin Babu. So he, Dinesh Babu, Parimal Ghosh, they had made a plan that they should teach a lesson to Bipin Babu, and that's why, children, they behave in that manner. Finally, when he got a good chance while writing a novel, he now he knew that he would get a nice money also, because publisher is now ready to take his novels. Okay, so he disclosed everything to Bipin Babu that it was he who had a plan to take revenge because he did not help him at the tower of his need. Okay, so with this, children, I end my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead. Bye-bye.